Mr. Wonka and the Indian, please. Prince Bondi chairs looked a little to Mr. Wonka, said Grandpa Joe, and asked him to come over with what the India and build him a custom palace entirely out of chocolate. Did Mr. Winkle Grandpa do it? Grandpa, he did indeed. I what the powers it does. It's a 100 rooms and everything was made of violet dark or light chocolate. When bricks were chocolate, a cement will chunk them together with chocolate, is a window with chocolate, and all the walls and ceiling made of chocolate, and make of the carpets with the pictures in the furniture and beds. And when you turn on the taps in the bathroom, hot chocolate came pouring out. When it was all finished, Mr. Wonka said to Prince Jerry, I warn you though, it will last very long, so we'd better stick in it right away.
No sense, said Prince.
I'm going to bring my palace, and I'm going to nibble a circus and lick the walls and look at living it. But Mr. Wonka would like a cup of tea too after this, but a very hot day in the boiling sun, and the whole palace began to melt, and was sank slowly to the ground, and the crazy prince, who was so dizzy and wriggling with the time, woke up to find himself swinging around a huge brown sticky lake of chocolate. Old Charlie sat very still on the edge of the bed, staring at the grandfather. Charlie's face was bright, and his eyes were stretched so wide that he could see the light over him. It's a windy chew, he asked, what is it on my leg?
It's chew, cried all four the old blood. Of course it's chew, it's anything else you like.
I tell you something else is chew, said Grandpa George. Then he said to Charlie in a subsequent whisper. Nobody ever comes out.
Out to where? Said Charlie.
And nobody ever goes in.
In where? Cried Charlie.
Wonka's factory, of course.
Grandpa, what do you mean?
I mean workers, Charlie.
Workers?
What factory? Stuck up Joe. The workers turn without the gates and the boarding is an impediment, except Wonka's. Have you ever seen a single person going to the place or coming out?
Well, Charlie. Looked slowly around each other four old faces, one after the other, and all looked back at them. They were friendly, smiling faces, but they were also quite serious. There were no signs joking, no light bulbing, or any of them.
Well, have you? Asked Grandpa Joe.
I didn't know, Grandpa Tommy's mother, and whether I work push the factory, we're looking good for.
Exactly, said Grandpa Joe. But there must be people walking there.
No people, said Charlie. No ordinary people anyway.
Then who? Cried Charlie.
Aha! That's good, Missy. But that's another of Mr. Willy Wonka's clevernesses.
Charlie, dear, Mr. Wonka said to the door, you're tied to bed, just in water tonight.
But Mother, I'm off here tomorrow, my darling.
That's right, said Grandpa Joe. I'll tell you the rest of it tomorrow evening.